Wer steckt denn auch sowas aus? Auf Batterie. Wer steckt denn auch sowas aus?
Ist das der? Ist das das letzte?
Ah, so, okay.
Okay, dann dauert es eine Minute. Man muss es ganz nah dran halten, oder?
Ist besser. Besser.
Genau. Also ich erzähle jetzt nicht viel über den Content, deswegen. Bei der nächsten Ankündigung vielleicht über Raspberry Pi. Oder für Einbord-Platinen vielleicht.
Beispiel.
Genau. Es ist ja das bekannteste Beispiel, deswegen habe ich das genommen. Oder für Einbord-Platinen
vielleicht. Okay. So, ja, dann fang einfach an, dann das wird sich sowieso.
Ja, ich werde dann gleich.
Okay.
System detected, das geht so wie.
Ja, es
so.
Kommt deutlich.
So und das. Ja.
Oder auch mit dem.
Mit dem hier.
Ja, weil ich würde dann gern das nehmen.
Ja. Das ist nicht ganz angenehm. Das geht so, genau. Es kommt deutlich.
Aber da gibt es keine B. Die B-Taste habe ich nur hier, ja.
Okay, can you please end the coffee break and come back to your seats? I'm sorry to interrupt your discussions.
So, okay, thank can you please very end the coffee break here. And come back I'm to your seats?
I'm sorry to interrupt your discussions.
I think you understand me if I take the microphone very close.
So, okay, can you please end
is it okay now?
Come back to your seats. I'm sorry to interrupt your discussions.
I think you understand. So I want to talk about is it okay now? Not so much about the LabDuo software, because I'm from the training physics and semiconductor scientist. So I have come to LabDuo about 2 years ago by the invitation of Dr. Friedrich Lange, who is the head of the lab Bonn, and I started to install computers and computers with LabDuo software about Lange. Can you understand me?
Who is the head of the lab
LabDuo software with the cloning, and I think it was maybe 300 laptops I did in the meantime. And at the same time, I was working software was in charge of the computer lab. Computer room in the refugee center in Bad Godesberg. And there I got a lot of practical experience about this LabDuo software, the Ubuntu, and the software which is installed in. But I do not want to concentrate so much on this part, but on the other part, during this experience, I learned that we have to think about that now we have basically laptops and desktop computers. But from my experience, I have this computer technology is changing all the time, and what will come in 2 years, in 5 years, in 10 years, nobody knows, and everywhere come more electronic parts. And when I worked at the semiconductor company, my task and my wish was you throw out all the computers every year, or maybe even every 6 months you buy a new telephone. And I had a friend when I was working in Japan who had recycling was his main topic, and he every weekend told me, what you do is so crazy, why you don't build computers which are more modular, that you take one part of the computer and make, for example, a new processor, and then you have a new computer again. And since then I was always thinking about it and saw how this all changed, how it became more compact, and now we have all the smartphones around which are so easy to carry. And when I went to the computer room in the refugee center, I carried a lot of laptops, and now we are used to carry maybe a tablet, maybe a smartphone, and these laptops are not so light. And I said, maybe I could find a different things. And one day I went to the makerspace and pulled out a drawer, and there were about 20 or 30 unused Raspberry Pis, so this one board computer. And I thought, maybe in 2 years they're old and nobody wants them anymore, and then they end up in a drawer, like our smartphones. And now, I thought, could we? Now, how I could use basically this one board computers and now in together with the LabDo.
And
for people who don't know, the LabDo is basically the Raspberry Pi. This is a one board computer. You have everything integrated on one board. And this one is the most popular one, and it's said to be one of the most sold computer in the meantime, like Commodore C64. So there will be a lot of electronic waste. But this one is easy to put together with other stuff,
like Commodore C64.
So here you see again, this is the front side and the back side. There's also another one, which has only a front side, even simpler to make. And please remember, this is just one example of such a one-board computer.
There's also another
and we will have in future a lot of these stuff, probably. So, and then,
and please remember, this is
when I talked with one refugee, he said, I have a nice computer, I have a nice TV at home, and why I have to use a laptop with a small screen, I want to use the TV for my screen. And then I brought him a Raspberry Pi and showed him how to install it. And since about 1 year, he is always using it and never breaking down, he's very happy. And then I said, okay, I installed the LabDo, Ubuntu software, and there is an Ubuntu version, but it didn't work so well. So that's why I will not say so much about the software. But it is a Linux, so it's basically the same as Ubuntu. And here you see now the components. It's the normal, very old, 10-year maybe old TV. Then you have the keyboard in a smartphone. You don't have the keyboard anymore. Then you have the mouse. You stick it all together, and you have a used power supply for the Raspberry Pi. So everybody has it at home at the moment. And you just need the power for the TV. So everybody with a TV and an old smartphone and a keyboard can use this stuff. And now many companies throw out their old monitors. So you can also use a monitor. You just buy a very cheap adapter, VGA to HDMI adapter. It costs from, I don't know, 3 euro to 20 euro, depending on where you buy it. But you need a little bit more power, and you see suddenly there is this power bank to support this adapter. The Raspberry Pi is too weak because he has a very low power, and he cannot supply the power for this adapter. The Raspberry Pi is so then, can we also go a step further? Yes, we can replace the power for the Raspberry Pi by a normal, or let's say a good power bank, which supplies sufficient power.
Can we also go a step further?
And now, let's go on. We could also use an old used tablet as a screen. When you use the VNCE remote connection, this is not ideal. Obviously, you need some here wireless connection, or some tablets have even some kind of HDMI port. Or you can go even further. You take a smartphone. Now the smartphones are quite big. So this is now getting more and more the normal size, especially when friends from Asia come, they always have this big one.
Now the smartphones are quite big.
So now we have the keyboard and the mouse, but you know nobody uses the smartphones with the keyboard and the mouse. It's a touch screen, so you have also the keyboard included. So, so now we have basically you can mouse, work like you this know, nobody uses and learn, learn. It's not for working, it's for learning.
Touch screen, so you have also the
and now you can even go to a smaller one. This is the so-called Raspberry Zero W.
It's not for working, it's for learning.
This is really, you can get it and now you can for under 10 euro.
Smaller one.
This is the so-called Raspberry Zero W.
Not for working, it's for learning.
Not for working, but for learning.
You can use
the, let's say, the Word and the Excel and make PowerPoint. And train
not
people
working,
on such
for learning.
Very
you
simple stuff. Anybody who has at home a laptop and a TV can basically learn this software.
On such for learning.
Very simple stuff. And it is Linux. And
laptop and a TV
to finish, learn before saying thank you. I want to and say that I tested basically almost all the software I found on the Lubuntu, installed it with a script, and at the bigger ones it basically all worked.
And say that I tested basically
thank you very much
for it. All the software I found on the Lubuntu, installed it with a script.
Thank you very much. You will have an opportunity to see everything he talked about in the room next to you. There is a complete Raspberry Pi. Thank you
door,
very much.
The right door there is a table where you have all the equipment set up. And this is a small thank you. Please give my regards to Dr. Lange as well from Habbon. This is a small thank you for joining us today. And now next is from Humanitas, Mr. Meyer Beerhorn. And he's as well working for Telekom as many of our contributors in Habbon do. And you are explaining about what you are doing in Tanzania in a school close Kenya in a school close to Mombasa.
Thanks a lot, Wolf, for joining us. Thanks a big thank you for this conference. I want to say this at this point. Thanks a lot. This is for you.
Thank you a lot.
Maybe you can help to find the right presentation because it's your laptop, not mine. I'm
sorry.
Working at Deutsche Telekom since 30 years and I will end in 2 years. So I have more time to support LabDo and also the.
I'm working at Deutsche Telekom since 30 years and I will end in 2 years. So I have more time to.
Not Switzerland.
Support LabDo and
that's
also
it.
The.
Yep. Thanks.
I'm working at Deutsche Telekom since 30 years and I will end in 2 years.
So we're happy to. Present Humanitas Activa. It's founded in 2011.
Thanks.
And we work close together since 5 years. And I think we have supported
so
in Uganda, Kenya more than 200 laptops.
It's
and now, in the next container next week, we have
we
about 150 big machines because Raspberry
Uganda,
will disappear in one of these pockets. So we have a complete other problem. In Kenya, it is a very interesting technology, I agree 100% Uli Egger, but if you have this small technology in Kenya, it is very problematic because they all disappear very soon. So the director, Mr. Oscar Andega, said to me, please come, please don't come with Raspberry, it's very interesting, please don't come with laptops.
So
we have big stress that they don't steal it and rub it away. Please come with big machines. So, completely different point of view.
Please don't come with laptops.
Located, our projects are located in the south of Mombasa, near Diani Beach, a very famous beach. We had some different projects in the north of Mombasa. Schools are still running with 400 and more children. And now we have kindergarten, Montessori kindergarten. Professional Vocational Institute, and this is the most focused today because I don't want to explain 2 hours and it's too boring for you. We are just focusing on the Professional Vocational Institute. On the right side, you see a very nice picture. If I wake up at 6 in the morning and have to run to the beach because we don't live next to the beach, it's too expensive. We live
on the right side,
far away, about
nice
2 or 3 kilometers.
I
have to walk, it's good for my
body,
and then I have this view if I on 6:20 in the near of the beach and can swim. Exactly at the equator, 12 hours light and 12 hours night. So it is, and it goes in 2 minutes. In the near of the beach and can swim. We are founded in April 2011, I told you, and more than 100% of our donated money, because we work a financial organization together, E and FC Stone, they make a good cause, so we have 15% more than it's usually. We have no fees in German side, we have no fees in the Kenyan side, and we get a good cause. Everybody is working voluntarily, nobody gets money, and even the flights and the when we stay there in January, I stay there for 11 weeks to build a new vocational institute. So you can read the common goals. We are focused on the childhood until graduation. It doesn't make sense to give them education until class 8 and then they're unemployed. We have an unemployment rate in Kenya about 70% in rural areas for the youth, and that's very bad. So we try a lot of things. This I want to discuss with you what we can do together. So one of the projects is Daraja, 400 children, 470 children, sorry. We feed daily with porridge, monthly eggs, bananas and milk. And so we have a lot of play materials like swings, table tennis, located there. A Montessori kindergarten we have in Diani since 3 years. And you can see the yellow tubes we are smuggled in the last container. It is not allowed to bring food in Kenya in the container, but we do this because it's sugar. Near Bonn is located a company called Rübenkraut, Grafschafter Goldsaft, and it's 100% sugar, and the children like it. We put it in the last corner in the container. And here you see the free work in the Montessori kindergarten, because 2 hours in the morning they can choose their work. Someone maybe knows what Montessori and, pedagogic is. They got a new sandbox and the kids are very happy. So now we can come to the focus of today. Yutzina Fundi Vocational Institute is a very long name. Oscar decided to do this because it means you can practical work if you finished and get a profession. This is the goal, to be independent, to earn your own money. Because if I discuss this with our students and say, if you are in the tailoring class and you make your graduation with B plus or A, means to earn your own money, 2 plus or 1, or the best graduation, you will get a bicycle and a sewing machine out of the container. So they are very motivated, and we have a high standard, so the students are running, and they have to pay a small amount every month, means 500 Kenya shillings, 5 euros a month, they have to pay of their own. So education has a value. All our institutes and schools are registered. This is very important. Otherwise, you have to pay corrupt money, and someone from the government close the school. We use the National Industries Training Authority, there they make the graduation. Here you can see of our control webcams, we can look in the classrooms. We have 4 cams, 124 hours, 7 days. And they work on Linux, Ubuntu, Leptix base with a small beamer. And we are looking for volunteers because this location will be the big first hub of LabDo in the future, where we distribute from our container the machines on small projects. Here you can see the tailoring class. They are producing gloves from our container and this is thing, I don't know the expression, I think it's apron, maybe it's the right word, they, you can use producing it for cooking. They do it very nice, and if you want to buy, you can do this. In the future, we plan a web shop. We have a small congress in Nairobi in the 7th until the 10th January next year, where we want together with a computer class, and we want to sell worldwide these things. So they are working together hand in hand, and with Flugpartner, we bring the things worldwide for free. CO2 neutral, we bring it home. So these things you see here are built in Kenya in our school, and people are coming back, they have an empty suitcase, they can take it with them. Here you can see the different colors, and in 4 weeks, Christmas is over, don't forget to buy Christmas present. You can do this.
Here you can see the different
there is someone in the kitchen and different prices.
Christmas is over.
And we have at the moment 46 students in 3 classes, tailor class, hairdressing class, and computer. The students manage of their own internet cafe, so they have small income. They print the passports, the photos for the passports they need in Kenya. And if you want to donate monthly for one student, it is 25 hours a month because the classes are small and every student has to bring 5 euros, 500 Kenya shillings of his own. So it becomes a value, as I told you. We make a 11 weeks trip, me, myself, I, other people 2 weeks, 4 weeks, different weeks, and we are looking for experts in IT, construction, solar, tailoring, because we have a big solar system, 10,000 watt on the roof, because we are the only one who has electricity, because Kenya Power removed, to enlarge the street, removed houses, and they cut off the cables. So our school has electricity around the clock. In Kenya, it's typically per month, 18 hours, it's off. In this area. We are collecting for the container. It will stand in my near at home in Bad Honnef for the next 4 weeks. So we have a lot of things that we can put in. We have nearly everything. If you have in your cellar, somewhere in your house, a sewing machine, I'm very happy if you send it to me. So the only thing what we need at the moment is our sewing machines. We have a good cooperation, as I told, with Mr. Ham Ralf, and he was honored by Chancellor Mr. Merkel 2016. We have a website, of course. You can donate on Facebook, on PayPal, and on the bank account, even with credit card. Because some people, they tell me, at the moment I have no money in the card, and I say, give me the credit card, no problem. So, we are very transparent. You can see every donor, every money, every euro in the internet. Many donors are not members, they just donate, they are companies they donate. You can see what I do very often is crowdfunding to give for different steps, different money. And we are looking for students, still looking for a donor, 8 students. So the next project journey is starting at the 6th of January. We are flying with 14 people, different skills they have, tailoring skills, IT skills, and so on. And we have a network in Kenya, in Malawi, with Promoting Africa, with Shangilia in Nairobi, and different vocational institutes and schools. And then we all come together in Nairobi to in the first week, starting from the 7th up to the 10th, like this we do, like do what you do here. And today we have a Saturday, and the students are playing football, typical, what we do, they do also today. So they made, 2 days ago, they made a video for us, for you, to evaluate, to say thank you, and we are showing them that we are working very close together. So you have a complete experience, because it's live. It was 2 days ago, and the last night, showing them that IT expert Jakob and his brother, thanks a lot. They made a wonderful video with the iPad and iMove. I don't know how to do this, so I'm so happy that we have these helpers.
They made a wonderful video with.
It's starting. So I'm quiet now.
I'm so happy that.
here. I want to thank you all for your big effort you put in our institution. You've been very supportive, and with a lot of enthusiasm you gave. We thank you for the donation of computers, and we thank LabDo for their software programs. And for now, I can report for the past year, the first students have graduated, 25 students have graduated for national exam, and they have all passed. And for now, so we are looking forward for a second lot of students. I want to show you what we do in our classes and how we do it in the classes. Thank you and welcome.
Das war noch wichtig, dass LabDo eingeblendet wurde. Er wollte es schon ausmachen, es geht doch gar nicht. Oh, sorry. He wanted to stop it and it was LabDo. So it was a nice feedback from Oscar and the students.
You see it live, what we are
doing there. They are very happy and proud.
We want us to stop it
and to get another level. So if you have any questions in the afternoon, I am standing there and make waffles for you. I make very special waffles and you can join me there. And you can ask a lot of questions. No, you have questions, right? Please.
Da?
Hello, everybody. First of all I want to say is I thank you very much for doing such a job, taking all this to some part of Africa. God bless you. God bless you. Amen.
Thanks.
My question is, is it only in Kenya that you're doing this stuff, or someday to come you will increase it, or you will take it to other part of Africa, or you're going to stay only in Kenya?
No, it's not only in Kenya. We support schools in Uganda and also in the future in Tanzania. I have a lot of questions from there, from the LabDo Hub Bonn, for example. They have some schools in Tanzania. So you have to decide. Mombasa is a harbor. There the container is located. From this point, we put it in our safe area behind big walls with security, so nobody can steal and rob anything. This is a very big problem in Kenya. Sorry, I have to say this. And from this point, we can distribute in the future several small schools and initiatives around, not in Kapstadt, of course not. It's too far away.
Yeah, what I'm saying is, where I come from in Africa, when people go to school, it's like they don't pass for the next level. For the next level, it's like they just roam about, and this comes out robbery, you know, drinking, and at the end of the day, it's like they have no hope. So my another question I want to ask is, can there be something that you guys could help that, I mean, through us here, we can do such, like what you do in Kenya, in my country where I come from, which is Ghana.
We have a lot of partners. Lab2 is focusing on the computer part of projects, but as there is Humanitas, there are about 200 other associations we are collaborating with in Germany. So there are, for instance, Mr. Hosu is from Düsseldorf, from the Ghana Association in Düsseldorf, and the concept which you have seen can be mirrored. So maybe you think about an approach not only shipping computers to Ghana, but also collecting sewing machines, taking care of correct usage at Ghana. But for Lab2, we are focusing on computer. You should check your network, you should check existing charitable organizations in Germany if they are able to contribute, or use your platform in Düsseldorf to start something familiar like this. I think from the logistics side, it doesn't make sense from Mombasa to Ghana, it's too far away. There is a vocational school from Mönchengladbach also joining. They run also a lot of projects in Ghana, so just the person in front of you is also contributing. Maybe you talk to each other. The day is just also a networking day, so just learn from each other. And I understand your question, but I have not a solution now, but maybe it's coming from the auditory, or you can talk to others.
Okay, thank you so much. At least there's somebody who can help me.
Okay.
Thank you so much, and I appreciate it.
Thank you. So now it, oh, sorry.
It just was a photo, I'm joking.
Okay. my name is Kevin Okoro. I'm a member of the Integration Council in Essen. So the project you're doing, I find it really, really great. And I had asked this question to the previous speaker. It's a very quite interesting thing. My question goes in, what are the strategies are you having to make it a more sustainable project because of the large challenges?
Two big challenges we have. Bureaucracy in Germany. If you want money from the government, from Bengo and Schmidt Stiftung and whatever, this is the one side here in Germany, and the corrupted people, even at the custom in Kenya. This is very bad. And these are the most challenges for me. Not the trust people there.
Yeah,
Oscar is 100% trust.
Yeah, yeah. Because it could be more effective when you have that in the sustainable aspect, you have the Kenyan partners, or mostly like the government that put in place.
Sorry again for taking the microphone. It's one of Lab2's idea to do everything in small steps. So each person traveling to Africa can take a laptop. Ghana Cargo, for instance, is doing all these logistics solutions for your association. They bring the computers to Ghana. I don't want to know how it is solved internally, but you can, of course, deliver large numbers of items like you do in your container, and it's a lot of administrative custom, etc. But Lab2 has another side of the medal. You can do everything in small steps. When you travel to your country and your project is accepted and on our website online, you can ask for 1, 2, 3 laptops to be taken to your home and just claim these laptops as your own. And no tax, no paperwork, nothing.
Okay,
that is the idea of Lab2, because we are aware of all these discussions and custom and bureaucracy.
Yeah, yeah.
And the best solution is to take just a few laptops. We prepared packages over there for some of your attendees to take them home. For instance, there is one delivery with 16 laptops. Our team worked on it for several weeks, and it's taken to Brussels, and then from Brussels, then travelers take one by one to Africa. So think about these approaches, that in small steps, you don't have to face so many problems.
No.
That is our concept.
Okay. Thank you so much.
I agree 100%. We have every second week someone who is coming from Mombasa, from Nairobi to Europe. It must not be, it's not necessary to be in Germany. And they bring it, we DHL or whatever, they bring it to me or other people of our organization. So also these things here, for example, is no problem. Also the other way with laptops or inverters for solar, whatever.
Okay, Ulrich, thank you very much. This is just a small present to remember Duisburg. Thank you for being here. And the next person is even more important than I am for LabDo. Thompson is our technical helper. He is repairing about every third laptop we get donated. So he needs his own laptop, oder?
Yeah.
Genau. I'm just unplugging everything.